Revels in our infinite capacity for friendship and love when we need them most. Do you like that? You're okay?
I am actually, but this is what I would call a sook book, Lee.
Sookie La La book, this
one. A sook book. If you're someone like me who sheds a tear at the drop of a hat, this is the book for you.
Well, it's a book that's set in a hospital, isn't it? So it's going to be a bit of a tearjerker.
It's a lovely story, though, about a beautiful friendship that develops between, well, sorry, we should say to you, the 100 yeah. years of Lenni and Margot. That is the combined age of the two main characters, 17 and 83. The 17-year-old.
She's got a terminal illness, and she becomes friends with an older lady who's in the hospital as well.
Who's a rebel.
She's a bit of a rebel, as you would be if you're going to be 83 years of age and haven't got long to live. And they find a friendship through art therapy. 100 years, obviously,
combined
of Lenni and Margot combined.
Yeah.
So, question.
Yep.
Does our age...
Gosh, no, don't even go there.
Come.
Dulce, we don't even reach 60. Oh, that's a lie. But no, we're nowhere near 100.
Sure.
No, we're not near 100. No,
shall
we
I give up how old I am?
Nope.
And then we can do the math to see whether... Nope. I reckon we might tip over. No, we will.
No, we don't.
Never ask a female
unless
how old
you're 60.
They are. This is why.
I haven't hit the halfway mark
this
yet.
Is why.
Thank you.
Okay, next. Anyway, it's a really good book.
Friendships.
It's a really nice book.
Friendships.
It's a friendship. They have a really good friendship, unlike our friendship, which has been tarnished
just
because
ruined.
I asked. It is a good story because they actually go on a, not a quest, but they paint 100 paintings. And so, you know, Lenni has 17 to paint, her age, and Margot has 83. So, and through the paintings, you find out the stories of how they've lived their life.
Yeah, I think it's such a lovely premise and it's really delicately done. It is a debut novel from Marianne Cronin and she spent
six years
writing it. And I reckon you can tell because it's just a really beautiful attention to detail. Like it's been lovingly crafted, which is a bit of a cliche, but it actually has. There's some beautiful moments. And I think also what's nice, of course, you know, we know that Lenni and Margot are our main characters, but there's all these kind of, you'd say cameos, but smaller characters to really add to it all. What I also think is beautiful about this book, we've seen a lot of films where we see older and younger main characters bond, but to have it in a book like this, it's really gentle, it's a really lovely way to see it. And I think also there's a lot of nice literature out there at the moment involving older people. So we talked about a book last year, Escape from the Woodlands Nursing Home.
Good memory.
Yeah.
Well
and
done.
So, yeah, that is good of me, isn't it? But, you know, like great books about older folks who are still kicking it and being a bit rebellious and getting out there in their later years. I love that this, to me, this isn't your style of book, but you still kind of have some affection for it, right?
Yeah, I didn't cry. I wasn't like you. I didn't go through a box of tissues, you know, but I got a little lump in my throat. So how many lumps are you going to give this?
Yeah, it's getting 4 lumps from me.
I'm going to give it 3.5 lumps.